one time ever, and this is it. So please, you have one time only to give us
the biggest round of applause of the night. She has never done stand up before. She's doing this one time only. Please welcome Linda Reynolds!
Is it still stand up if I sit down?
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Yeah. I still get paid, yeah?
No, no one is getting paid.
But I'm headlining.
Well, you're not headlining. Two more after you. Hurry up.
Right, okay. Who's headlining, may I ask?
A checklist.
Your cock's dropped.
Carrie Ann Odling is
which
one headliner. Is not here yet.
Okay.
We hope she turn up.
Relative, I take it, yeah. Yeah. Okay. No, no, it's okay. Got it. Right, okay, I've never done this before. I'm never going to do it again. And before I start, I've got a few things I do need to kind of clear up. That's my crib sheet, which I will be using. I'm 63. I can't remember where I left my dog. So I won't remember what I was supposed to be saying. Actually, I do remember where I left my dog, but that wouldn't have sounded the same, would it? If I'm 63 and I can remember where I left my dog. It would have made me sound quite weird. The second thing is no heckling, please. Okay, I'm just not quick or bright enough to respond, and I'll probably just take the Dennis Waterman approach, okay, and give you a slap. And you won't be able to consider yourself an abused audience, okay? Because I did warn you, all you have to do is keep your mouth shut. And you'll be the fucking cover. And thirdly, there's nothing complex, nothing intelligent, nothing subtle in anything I'm going to say tonight. You can all relax. Okay, I'm aware that I am in Medway. I've removed all trace of irony. If you don't laugh, it's not because you don't understand, it's because it's just not funny. yeah, okay, I shouldn't really say that about Medway. It's actually been my home for 20 years, and I quite like Medway. I was on my way somewhere else. Stuck here. I was a primary school teacher in Medway. Yep, they actually let me near their children. And there's some fantastic schools. Anybody got kids in Medway schools here? No?
Yes.
Yeah? Yeah? Okay, they're in safe hands. I can tell you that. We have some fantastic schools in Medway. I don't know whether you know, but Medway is the only education authority in the entire country that's been allowed to opt out of the Ofsted inspections. Did you know that? Well, not exactly opt out, but they've just got a different way of doing it. And what they do is they send the inspectors round to the school gates every day for a week, and they just count the staffies. We never tested kids in the school that I taught in. I think it's really cruel, actually, testing children. If they were called Jason, we'd just put them straight on the special needs register. we had a few traveller children in my class as well. Actually, it was really good for the other kids because it taught them how to do takeaway. That's probably the only politically... Was that racist? No? Oh, God, shit. I wanted to do one racist joke. You know, racist or a fucking Marxist. Racist joking. I've just got back, in case you haven't noticed, I've just got back from Thailand. These are called fisherman's trousers, by the way. Word of warning, don't wear them in Medway, okay? Because I got run out of Chatham for eating satsuma in public. Coming round here with your fancy ways. I learned to snorkel actually when I was in Thailand. Something I've always wanted to do. I went snorkeling in the Andaman Sea. It's beautiful. I had a really good instructor. He was really, really good. He was very, very calm, which I wasn't. And he explained. He said, "Put the mask on." He said, "Make sure it covers your eyes. Make sure it covers your nose. Do all the breathing through your mouth." I thought, I can do that, so put my mask on and pulled it right down. Started to panic straight away. I'm a bit claustrophobic, you know. Started to panic, ripped the mask off, felt really embarrassed. He said, "Look, don't worry. Don't worry." He said, it's because you do all your breathing through your nose. He said, "You're what we call a nose breather." Actually, what you said was, "You're what we call a nose breather. Can I buy you a drink?" I had a massage when I was there. A lovely, beautiful, beautiful Thai woman. She was called... I'm not actually gay. Mind you, I didn't do stand-up till tonight, so no. She used coconut oil, it was lovely. And one of the guys, actually, he was a bit, it was disgusting, actually. He said to his masseuse, he said to her, "Can I have a happy finish?" It's horrible, isn't it? That's horrible. She took it well, though. She gave him her iPod and put on Cliff Richard singing "Congratulations." One of the other guys, he got a little bit confused. He asked us to finish him off. Got down a Cohen. Nick's actually been asking me to do this for a while, and various reasons I couldn't come here. In February it was London Fashion Week, obviously I couldn't make that. Then I went off to Thailand, and he's been asking me for a long time, and I had a feeling that it was a bit of an ulterior motive, actually, to him asking me, and I think he thought it'd be good for me. I wasn't actually going to talk about this. Okay. I think he thought it cathartic. I think is the word. You see, I'm just getting over a broken heart. I'm sorry. Yeah, it's a bit of a story, actually. Just give me a minute. See, a few years ago, I caught something called bipolar disorder. I don't know if you've heard of it yet. It used to be called manic depression, and posh people started to get it, so they changed the name. it sounds a bit dangerous, doesn't it? When my dad got it in the 40s, it was still called manic depression then, but let's face it, nobody with bipolar disorder is going to name a neighbour to the floor and set fire to the cat. Good old dad. So I caught bipolar disorder, and then my partner of 17 years actually was here, he started to behave quite strangely, actually. He started bleaching the cups and just kind of weird stuff, and eventually he came out and he said I'm ending our relationship. He said, that illness, he said, has destroyed the person you are. He said, it's It destroyed us as a couple. He said, it's incurable, you'll have it for the rest of your life. He said, and don't bother having another relationship, because it'll destroy that one too. I know. Actually, he wanted to fuck a woman who lived on the Hoop Peninsula. But he didn't want to say that because it made him sound bad. The Hoop Peninsula, for anybody who doesn't know, it's a long way, it's really
cut
off. I lived there myself for a few years. In fact, there's a couple of people who used to live on the Hoop Peninsula. Justine, how long did you live on the Hoop Peninsula for?
5 years.
About 5 years. Did your toes grow together at all? Yeah. It's great for swimming, isn't it? But it's a fucker getting your flips off. Anyway, eventually, you know, he got together with the woman from the Hoop Peninsula. They started living together. Not straight away. Sorry, I don't want to give you the wrong impression about this man. He did some really deep and painful soul searching during that week. eventually they got together and then something really, really strange started to happen, even stranger than that lot, right? She started putting all the details of their sex life on a social networking site. Now, I don't do social networking. I've got enough trivia in my life without logging into somebody else's trivia. You know what I mean? I don't do it. Right? But all the details went on. It was my friend Caroline that told me, because she didn't want me to be hurt. She didn't want me to find out another way. Really good friend. So she would tell me, detail by detail, what was going on. And to be supportive. We all need a friend like Caroline. And she would have been here tonight, actually, to support me, but she's had to go back into hospital to have her nipples realigned. it was sad, actually. She decided a few months ago that her boobs, they weren't big enough, they weren't firm enough. You know, they looked fine to me, not as good as mine, you know. But they looked all right, and she went into another operation, and would you believe it, halfway through, fucking power cut. So they tried to carry on, you know, somebody had a candle, you know, they tried to carry on. They're not gods, properly, you know, they're not gods, they make mistakes, you know, and it looked like a nipple. they didn't see the hairs. Anyway, she's gone back in, you know, and to have a realigned rebound. I don't know what they use. Is it a spirit level? Anyway, she's there. So all the details started to go on, and boy, were there some details. Apparently, they were having sex in all different locations, including the back of his V-Reg Iveco. He got the model with the sliding door because he said it was easy to get big items in. I didn't mean that. That wasn't my intention, I'm sorry. No, I would never comment on another woman's appearance. You know, I did women's studies at university. I would never do that. You know, it's not right. It's demeaning to me as a woman. And it's not her fault. You know, we can't all be blessed with a neck. And, I was hearing all about these details, and to be honest, I had no idea that he was into that stuff. You know, he never told me. 17 years we were together, he never told me. If he told me, you know, I'd have found a Jerusalem artichoke from somewhere. He no, it's all right for her. She's a fucking chef. She's got access to this. I mean, off in Gillingham, broccoli's considered exotic. Anyway, funny enough, of all the details that she'd gone, there was one that she left off, and I can't understand it, really. What she didn't mention is that when he comes, he sounds like a seal that's been harpooned from the thorax. I think I might have said enough. I'm sorry, I'm going to go. Before I do, can I just ask that you all use the antiseptic hand wash that I've left at the door? Because I don't want any of you catching bipolar disorder. I believe in that you can do stand-up comedy.